Very good morning, children. Today I'm going to teach you our first lesson of term 2. So today I'm going to explain you this lesson and I will let you read the lesson. Okay, what is the title of our first lesson? Stone soup. So our first section is warm up section. So there are many types of soaps. How many have you tasted? Name them. So there are so many types of soups, right? What are they? Chicken soup, tomato soup, lot of types of soups are there. If you drink any or if you tasted any kind of soups, you have to write their names here. Okay. So let us read the lesson first. Once a man named Henrik went to a village. So who went to a village? Henrik, who is a man, went to the village. So what happened there? He was very hungry. He was very, very hungry. He wants to eat anything. So what he has done? He knocked at the door of a house. A woman opened the door. See here, he is Henry, who was so hungry. So what he has done? He knocked the door and a woman opened the door. So what happened next? I am hungry. Please give me some food, he asked. The woman did not want to share her food with Henry. I don't have any food, she said. So what happened? When the lady opened the door, Henrik is asking to the lady, what is that? I'm so hungry. Please give me some food, he asked the woman. So what woman has replied? The woman doesn't want to share her food with anyone. So she said, I don't have any food. So Henrik knew she was lying. He had an idea. I have a magic stone. I will make some stones soup for you, he said to the woman. So what happened? Henrik already knew that she is lying, doesn't he? Yes, she is lying. Henry found that she is lying. So he had got an idea. What is that idea? He said, I have a magic stone. I will make some stone soup for you. So he said, I have a magic stone. So I will make a magic soup if you want to, he asked the woman. So what woman has replied? Teach me how to make stone soup, the woman said. The woman asked him, so how to make that stone soup? You have to tell me. That way the woman has asked the Henrik. So what happened? Henrik went to the kitchen. Where did Henrik went? Henrik went to the kitchen. He put some water in a pan and put the pan on the flame. He then put a stone into the pan. So what happened next? Henrik went to the kitchen to teach the lady the stone soup. So what happened next? He put some water. He kept some water on the pan and he kept that pan on the stove and he let the stone in the pan. So the water is heating along with the stone. So what happened next? See, Henrik is cooking something, right? So Henrik is saying that Henrik tasted the water. He said the soup tastes good. It will taste better with salt and onions. So he said that the soup tastes so good. What he had done? He did nothing. He kept the water and he kept the stone. And he tasted it and he said the soup was very nice. But if we add some onions and the salt, it will be very nice, he said to the lady. So what happened next? The woman chopped some onions and put them into the pan and added some salt too. Hendrik stirred the soup with the spoon. He then tasted it. Stirred means he is rotating the spoon. She cut the onions and she added the onions into the soup, and also she added some salt. So the Hendrik is stirred. That means he is rotating the spoon. Okay. So he said the soup tastes good, but it will taste better with the potatoes. So then he asked the potatoes. So then he told the lady that if we add some potatoes, it will be so nice. So the woman cut some potatoes and put them into the pan. So what woman has done? She again cut the potatoes, and she kept that potatoes into the pan, and again the Hendrik stirred the soup and tasted it again. The soup is very good, he said, but it will taste even better with some beans and tomatoes. The soup smelled good. The woman was hungry. She cut some beans and tomatoes and put them into the pan. So what happened? He said, first he asked for the onions. Again he asked for potatoes, and now he is asking for some tomatoes and beans. The lady was so hungry. So what she had done? She cut tomatoes and the beans too, and she mixed it into the soup. So at last the soup was ready. Hendrik took out the stone, then he poured some soup into a bowl. So in the end the soup was ready. How it went? He added some water first, then the tomatoes, then the beans, then the potatoes, and then the onions and the salt. So the soup is ready. So what happened next? So Hendrik was saying, please take the magic stone. He had some stone, right? He gave that stone to the lady and he said, please take the magic stone, said Hendrik to the woman. You can make stone soup every day, but remember to put in some salt, onions, potatoes, tomatoes and beans too. This is how the story ends. See, they both are having the soup. So what happened? First, Hendrik was so hungry. He knocked the woman's door. He asked for the food. She said she don't want to share her food with the Hendrik. So she said, I have no food. So Hendrik offered her, I will prepare some stone soup if you agree. So the woman asked Hendrik, yeah, of course. Teach me how to do the stone soup. So Henry started doing the stone soup. How he did? First, he went to the kitchen and he poured some water into this pan and the stone. He had only the stone. The stone he kept in that pan. And he asked the lady to cut the onions first and add some salt. So first the lady cut the onions and she added the onions into the pan along with the salt. After he asked for the potatoes, and the lady cut the potatoes and she added that to the soup, and then tomatoes and beans. And the Henry was stirring the pan. So finally he made the soup and he gave that stone to the lady and asked her to do the soup in the same way he did. So this is how the story ends. Now the reading part. You have to repeat the lesson after me. Now I am going to read the lesson. Okay. So what is the title of our lesson? Stone soup. You have to repeat the lesson after me. Stone soup. Repeat after me. Once a man named Hendrik went to a village. He was very hungry. He knocked at the door of a house. A woman opened the door. I am hungry. Please give me some food, he asked the Woman. The woman did not want to share her food with Henrik. I don't have any food, she said. Henrik knew she was lying. He had an idea. I have a magic stone. I will make some stone soup for you, he said to the woman. Teach me how to make stone soup, the woman said. Henrik went to the kitchen. He put some water in a pan and put the pan on the flame. He then put a stone into the pan. Henrik tasted the water. He said, "The soap tastes good. It will taste better with the salt and the onions." The woman chopped some onions and put them into the pan. She added some salt too. Henrik stirred the soup with the spoon. He then tasted it. He said, "The soup tastes good, but it will taste better with the potatoes." The woman cut some potatoes and put them into the pan. Henrik stirred the soup and tasted it good. And tasted it again. "This soup is very good," he said. "But it will taste even better with some beans and tomatoes. The soup smelt good. The woman was hungry. She cut some beans and tomatoes and put them into the pan. At last, the soup was ready. Henrik took out the stone. Then he poured some soup into a bowl. "Please take the magic stone," said Henrik to the woman. "You can make stone soup every day. Remember to put in some salt, onions, potatoes, tomatoes and beans too." So children, what you have to do is, you have to read the whole lesson at least 2 times. This is your homework today. Okay. So, now we will do the understanding the text. Okay. See, read the statement, tick if it is true and cross if it false. Henrik went to a village. Is it right or wrong? It is a right statement. Okay. So, the door was opened by a boy. No, right? The door was opened by a girl. So, it is wrong. Henrik was thirsty. No, he was hungry. So, it is also a wrong statement. The woman was ready to share food with Henrik. Is it right or wrong? No, the woman doesn't want to share her food with Henrik. So, it is also a wrong statement. The woman wanted to learn to make stone soup. Is it right or wrong? Yes, it is right. So, Henrik put some corn in the soup. Does he put corn? No, he put some salt, some onions, some potatoes and some beans. So, it is a wrong. It was a wrong statement. Okay. So, see, pick the vegetables that Henrik used to make soup. Does he use tomatoes? Yes. Does he use beans? Yes, he used beans. Does he use brinjal in the soup? No, right? So, it is wrong. So, see, potatoes. Yes, he used potatoes. Does he use carrots? No, he doesn't use carrots. So, it is a wrong. It is a strong vegetable name. Okay. So our next section is discuss and write. Read these lines from the story. I have a magic stone. I will make some stone soup for you. Why do you think Hendrik sent these lines, these words to the lady? Discuss in the class. So you have learnt or you have listened the story, right? So why he had to say that he had a magic stone and he can make a stone soup for the two men? Why he said that so? Because the woman doesn't offer food for him. But he was so hungry. Then he got a thought. So he said those words to eat the food. Okay. Okay, children, you have to do all these romans. And along with that, you have to read the lesson and the grammar part at least 2 times. Thank you.